ti veio e poi Thailand sangue le sorti selection a to work and work and le donne a e combina poi fundan anche che apply and tan tem mm ma che mani lamtan a cha han chan kha harsa zok ma applicants and deserving mm tiamna may ba ka tenge Mizoram India ram le cover ta na chatem ngai chlai ta ta kan nom te kan share the fine kan lom mm ma e a final applicants to thing at link kan so fine he ka om nam thi e Oxford University Radcliffe camera a main landmark ania helai mun a hang thing e ka tik he at kan ti chuan chlai te Mizoram zofa te ye Mizoram chung khel lo po lai amara a nam shang shang e mun shang shang on ten helai hun a hian zirna sang zok panin helai hun a hian kan ron kal ve theya kan thei ve ni kan tin ve ni ti hi e tuna ron tling thar ta ti po e in malam in zir zo in zir chau ta tur zela nge in nge tu na me me tan e om se ti kha setting a tan karon mang do ni chu. And without much further ado, this will be the top finalists will be representing Mizoram at Asia Pacific Youth Exchange 2020 Thailand. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Kesila Pek Lui and I'm from Mizoram, India. Among the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, I would love to work with goal number 4, that is quality education, because I'm a firm believer that when we support quality education, we give a child a better career opportunities, which further contributes to the all-round development of our society. My state, Mizoram, is among one of the highest literacy rate in India, but it is not a figure that we have to be proud of because our current educational system is unable to produce enough graduates who really can compete with graduates from different parts of the states or different parts of the world. So I think it's a time that we have to really focus from the roots, that is from elementary schools, and neglect our traditional way of learning, that is by heart system, as it is the right as well as the necessity of every children to receive quality education.
Hello, my name is Michael V. L. Chandama and I am from India. I am a research scholar at Jain University, Bangalore, India. And I want to thank the Asia Pacific Youth Exchange for the response of my online registration. Out of the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, I want to work and actually currently working on goal number 7, which is affordable and clean energy. The world is currently at a global energy and climate crisis because of the over-exploitation of fossil fuels as the main energy source. So we need an alternative source of energy which can reduce or replace the use of these conventional fuels. Therefore, I am working on the production of biodiesel from microalgae, which aims at producing a biodiesel which is clean and cost-effective with the same efficiency as that of the conventional diesel. And working on this goal will also help to attain goal number 13, which is climate action.
Hello everyone, my name is Aisla Ankoli from the state of Mizoram, India, and one of the northeastern state of India. Among the 17 sustainable development goals, I would like to work on the first objective, that is no poverty. And I'm a research scholar from Mizoram University, and I have been working on financial inclusion among street vendors in Lungle, Mizoram. And I found out that most of the weaker section lack awareness about the government scheme provided by Indian governments, and I observed the financial literacy is low. The reasons behind existing scenario could be low quality of education, gender inequality, discrimination, exposure, etc. To eradicate poverty, not only the monetary scheme cannot fulfill the need. So, rather we have to help them develop the skill and promote education, which in turn leads to achieve the goal, no poverty. Thank you.
Hello, greetings from Mizoram, India. My name is Ephraim and I'm a research scholar of management department, Mizoram University. Among the 17 sustainable development goals, I would like to work on goal number 12, that is responsible consumption and production. The reason I chose this topic is that as our consumption patterns and production can have negative impact and positive impact in our environment. So a consumer like you and me and the producers plays an important role in this part. And you know, this goal number 12 connects to several part of the sustainable development goals, such as clean water, sustainable cities, good health, life below water and life on land, so on and so forth. So this is one of the most important goal among the 17 goals, according to me. And another reason why I choose it so big is that, you know, as far as my state is concerned, India, as we know that India generates more than 200,000 tons of plastic waste every day. You know, that is every day. So there is a lot to do from the individual perspective, you know, families, societies, government, producers, and everyone, in order to achieve a sustainable environment for today and tomorrow's generation. Therefore, out of these 17 goals, I would like to give my first priority to this goal so that we can discuss and share with other delegates on how to arrive at a better solution, you know, the way of segregation, collection, recycling, the mechanism as a whole.
Hi, my name is Katrina, and I'm currently working as a teacher here at the Daniel School, Aizong, Mizoram. With regards to the SDGs in 2030, I would like to personally work upon goal number 4, that is quality education. Well, as a teacher, for us to truly grasp the essence of the term quality, I believe that there has to be a standard measure to what we consider as quality education. The condition of the private school in India might vary, but in Mizoram, private schools provide a budding platform. But sometimes it fails to meet the fullest potential due to lack of funds. So if we could generate a funding base based on different stakeholders, then I believe that we could achieve these goals by 2030. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Yoram Hinkloa. I'm from Mizoram, India. As we know, all 17 SDGs are interconnected and linked with each other. For APOA Thailand 2020, I would like to work on SDG number 7, which is ensure access to affordable, reliable, sustainable, and modern energy for all. Because due to depletion of energy sources, natural energy sources in the world, requirement of renewable energy increases day by day, and around 16% of the world population do not have access to electricity. And a small state like Mizoram is also struggling in achieving electricity for all. And the government of Mizoram is also taking lots of initiatives in these fields also. And I believe that we have the potential in achieving these goals. And due to its peculiar nature, and it requires only study and improvements in these fields. And I hope that we can learn and discuss together in APOA Thailand 2020 and build a better future for all. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Arvad Fili, and I'm a third year MBBS student. If given the opportunity, I would like to work with SDG 3, Good Health and Well-being. In my home state, Mizoram, about half of the total population lives in the rural areas where healthcare facilities are still not easily accessible despite the fact that they are the ones who need the most. Healthcare has to be made easily accessible and affordable for everyone. Unfortunately, Mizoram currently has the highest adult HIV prevalence in India and is among the states where malaria is the most prevalent. Mental health is also a challenging concern because depression, suicide, and drug abuse are on the rise. We also know that Mizoram has a rich variety of plants which are known to have medicinal properties, yet scientific and medical research in this field is still very limited. I want to conclude by saying that we still have so much to learn, improve, and discover in the field of health, and I want to take part in it.
My name is John Laram Hunanamte, hailing from the Indian state of Mizoram. After careful deliberation, I have decided to take up goal number 8, which envisage decent work and economic growth for all people. I have chosen this goal with a particular interest in mind, and that is the inclusion of persons with disabilities as one of the main targets. I am extremely delighted that one of the main agendas of this goal, goal number 8, as it is envisaged in the global targets, is the attainment of productive employment for all people, with special reference to persons with disabilities. I have endeavored to work in whatever capacity I can render for the attainment of the SDG goals pertaining to the upliftment of disabled people, especially in sectors and areas like education and employment. In my experience working for the disabled people, I have made the observation that vocational training and targeted skill development are most viable options to bring about sustainable and productive employment. I have also envisioned to bring about structural and effective changes in the policy formulation that will accommodate all kinds of disabilities and make special provisions for them, especially in areas like employment generation and job reservation. In doing so, I believe my endeavor epitomizes the spirit of goal number 8, that is inclusive growth and development for all people. Inclusivity is the key. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Lamning Sangi Pachuao from Aizawl, Mizoram, currently pursuing my MPhil from the Department of Psychology at Mizoram University. Of all the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, I want to work on goal number 4, that is quality education. Because I have worked in a school where there is less facilities due to the inadequate fundings, the difficulties that the children faced have affected their education in numerous ways. So, a quality education is one of the most important and the best way to improve or change one's life, regardless of race, gender, and socioeconomic status. When a person is provided with proper and quality education, a person becomes more emotionally and mentally strong, socially competent, and have a better lifestyle and well-being. Lastly, I also believe that with the aim of achieving universal access to higher education and by eliminating gender and wealth disparities, ensuring that all children will get education will make a change in our education system in India and all around the world. Education is one of the best platforms to give awareness about everything and anything. So when we work on education, other goals such as gender equalities, peace and justice, and so on can be taken care of.
Hello, this is Vanar Zarzoliana, an applicant of APYE 2020 from Mizoram, India. The goal that I'd like to work on is goal number 2, zero hunger. In India, 30% of the fruits and vegetables that are harvested rot before they get to the people that need the most due to lack of proper cold storage facilities. Globally, in every 10 seconds, we lose a child to hunger. It is estimated that 1/3 of the food produced in the world is wasted. The world will need to produce at least 50% more food to feed 9 billion people by the year 2050. I think it's certain, but if we don't talk the talk and walk the walk, who will? By working together, we can achieve food security and put an end to hunger. These are some of the reasons why I chose this goal, Zero Hunger, over the other 16 Sustainable Development Goals.